Hey nerds, I'll keep this quick. This is a Just Out the Seat for Newsies. I'm pretty sure it's the Broadway musical that is circulating at some theaters right now, as it is, I believe, either the 15th or the 20th anniversary. I'll jump straight into it. It's a Disney movie, so it does have this kind of like cheesy look on life. It's about a newspaper strike in New York during like the Industrial Revolution, and it's very, very awe-inspiring. I mean, performance-wise, I'd say that seeing it like live would have been amazing, but it does feel like such a gift to be able to see it on screen. The set transforms throughout the piece. They have like almost like this Lego, or maybe it's like metal blocks, the magnet ones. Their set disassembles and reassembles very, very easily, and although there are a lot of props for different scene elements, like the gridlock in the city of New York is represented really well and very simply, I guess. It looked like a very complicated mechanism, to be sure. But it looked like the cast could move it by themselves. All the equipment was on wheels, obviously, to make it easier. But it's definitely a marvel of theatrical prowess. Really enjoy watching this entire piece, which was like, I want to say around 2 hours, 15 minutes. The noise you can hear around me is people now editing. There was actually, instead of trailers, a 15-minute intermission about halfway through, or two-thirds through, which gives you a great reprieve and something I'm not used to in a movie theater. Really enjoyable. The movie / play / book, which I actually read in my childhood, is pretty old, so I'm not too worried about spoilers, but I'm not gonna get super into it. It is about a newspaper strike, and basically this is during the time where children were working in sweatshops around the world, and it was totally okay for someone who, you know, was less than 18 to not go to school ever and just work to support their family. Think about immigration and, you know, families living, you know, like four or five to a single room for families, I would say. Not all the newsies are orphans, but a lot of them are. The poverty that's touched upon is like very, very, very heart-wrenching. But because it is a musical, there is a lot of singing and dancing, which sometimes makes you forget that. But there are happy songs and there are sad songs, obviously. So the emotions aren't really ever just left in the air, I'll say. I mean, if you're used to musicals or used to plays in general, I'm sure you're used to the energy being as it is, and a lot of highs and lows in this play. The story isn't too complex, I would say. Feels historical, but also fantastical. I think it is really nice to see just minors empowered. It's really awesome, and just like the younger generation kind of trying to find their seat at the table, as the play would even suggest. The next generation inheriting the old generation's responsibilities is a common theme that you might enjoy or despise. And I think seeing it right now really reminds me that there's a lot of stuff going on in the world right now, especially in America. And given like this kind of dirty thing in our past, not even the dirtiest thing in our past, is something still to like think about and look at and say, well, I mean, if they did that for these reasons, who's to say that things that are happening right now aren't happening for similar reasons? What I mean is just politics determining where we're going, obviously. Right now, a lot of people have a lot of gripes with the current administration. A lot of people have problems with the way the youth culture is. I mean, I guess that's pretty common everywhere, all the time, no matter what decade, no matter what generation. But I guess seeing it represented in sing and dance form, and like a past generation that did the same thing to the preceding generation, is really telling on how history repeats itself and whatnot. If you don't like musicals, you don't like Disney movies, you're probably not gonna like it. I would say definitely check it out if it's still around. It was only supposed to be going around for 3 days, so definitely Google it, see if you can find it in your area. If you can actually see the play as it runs. I don't know if it's still running, but I think maybe it is. I'll post a link if I can find it. Anyone who thinks they might enjoy Newsies, just in general from the things I've said, I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that it inspires you to community action. I know that's like also kind of left field, but I don't know, striking and revolution are real big buzzwords right now, unfortunately and fortunately. And given the women's strike recently, it's really hard to ignore that. Things need to change, and people in power are not gonna change it by themselves because they have no reason to. So sometimes revolution and putting someone in a corner is kind of what you have to do. And ironically, I've had this movie marathon today. I went from John Wick, which had a lot of murder and revenge and very masculine feeling in a lot of ways, even though it fetishized Italian suits and things made to order specifically for you. And then went to Fist Fight about like responsibility and people having to own up to their shit, which is also kind of a masculine thing to think about. And then go to Newsies, which is kind of a coming of age story, so boys becoming men in a way, while still kind of basking in like this energy of youthfulness, but having to, regardless of all that, like kind of be more adult than they thought that they were. In Newsy specifically, I'd say that the kids were already living in poverty before the events of the play start. However, in kind of coming into their own, they can enjoy life more, but life hasn't really changed for them much than it was at the beginning of the story, in a way. Things are set up to be better, but the general impoverished conditions were far from over. And as someone from Chicago, where the Industrial Revolution had a huge effect, I try to remember the grisly history that happened and how many people died just trying to make a living. So because we have the burden of the world being much more complex now and suffering being multifaceted, and the fact that people who come before us definitely would say that things are better than it ever was, so how dare you complain? I'd say that keeping a good perspective is important, and that changing someone else's perspective is one of the hardest things you can do. And I'm sorry to spoil it, but the Newsies did it. They, on at least terms set by their leader, kind of won the strike. Unions are important, but if you think about it, not every job has a union still today, and a lot of people work jobs for 20, 30, 40 years without protection from their employers. I know that sounds like I'm definitely have my mind made up about how things should be, but how can I not, that we kind of live in a world where everyone's expected to have their opinion pretty much said already. I mean, for this to get so thick with negative energy, I guess. But Newsies is also really, really depressing. Like, I tried to also remember, although Newsies is filled with white people, they were facing problems that many people face today without thinking about race. I know that's kind of a reverse of how you want to do things now, because if you erase race, then you erase culture. But I thought it was interesting, because if you think about white immigrants who came to this country looking for work and the conditions they faced, it's pretty similar to what other people faced when they came to this country, regardless of how they came here. And people who saw that there was a better life because certain other people were living in America have been fighting for the right to have the opportunities for just a good life for as long as dirt's been around, I guess. I hope you nerds are having a good week and a good February. I hope I can do some more videos soon. And remember what I said.